Proxy files and optimized media. These are two options DaVinci Resolve gives me to temporarily replace my source media with something that works better with my current processing, editing, fusion, color grading. So in this tutorial, I want to have a closer look at what those workflows are, what the relevant settings are, what you can expect out of it, especially when it comes to performance with editing or fusion color. What impact does it have or does it not have? This is kind of the second tutorial in a series about performance with DaVinci Resolve. Last time I took a more fundamental look at codecs, what codecs are suitable, how you can find out which codecs work well with your computer and which don't, and how you learn more about and explore the codecs you're using. So if that is of interest to you, I highly encourage you to look at this as well. Now I'm more looking at the setup directly in Resolve and how I can use this right away. I would also like to encourage you to have a look at my website if you haven't done so already. I am offering more complete training courses, especially in Fusion. I have a free Fusion beginner course and some more advanced courses as well. So if you like some more detailed, in-depth kind of explanation, have a look there as well. But first things first, let's have a look at proxy files and optimized media. The typical starting point why you might want to use optimized media or proxy files is that you are in the edit page and some of the clips may not play back well, or you can't scrub through them very quickly, and you find somehow that the system is lagging and you think, okay, maybe it's related to the codec, maybe it's related to the files themselves, can I improve something? Especially if you find out that in a project some clips work very well and maybe others don't. So here I have a project with lots of different media. There's some like 6K B-RAW and some Ultra HD H.264 and some ProRes codecs. Now, typically I would expect the ProRes codecs to perform super great and maybe the raw media not so great and the H.264 also not so great. And I spoke more about the codecs last time. So if you have reason to optimize, you have two options. Both of them are available via right-click basically. You can generate optimized media here, or you can generate proxy media. Let's look at both of them, and first of all, let's see where they actually end up and where the settings for these are. So in your basic preferences, you have settings under media storage, where you can list different locations where you typically want to access files in Resolve, and the first location by default, as it says in the naming underneath, is your default setting for optimized media, cache, proxy media, and so on. That is just the default, so whenever you create a new project, this is the default place to look at. If you want, you can override this in your master settings of the project settings you have down here, file locations. And the location I'm interested in now is the cache file location, and that is called cache file, but it's used also for optimized media and it's used for the proxy media. So if I look into the folder, so under sResolve, I have all the, that sResolve is the basic folder, right? And then you have the subfolders, and in there I find my proxy media, if I have created any, which I haven't done so, and then cache file, and in there, in this cache clip folder, is also the optimized media, which I have some now. Let me just delete it for this tutorial. And now let's start optimizing. First, let's have a look at the resolution settings. So I will start with the proxy media workflow and then talk about the optimized afterwards. So proxy media is a workflow where you are creating alternative clips, full clips of your source clips. So you create clips in the same duration, same length. They appear in the file system practically the same way like the original one, just in typically a lower resolution or a more optimized codec. So the codec first, so here I'm under Windows, that's why I have the DNxHR codecs. If you are under Mac, you may see the ProRes codecs. Instead, I talked about them last time, but just quick reminder, low bandwidth at the bottom creates the smallest files and the lowest resolution, great for edit proxies if you just quickly have to skim through all your media, maybe do a quick edit. If you need the full quality for color grading, and if you have good quality source material, you typically want to go to the higher options, and the highest options are especially relevant in case you also want to render from your intermediate files. So if you have heavy raw footage, which is tough to process on your computer, you can transcode it into this type of footage. The file size might even get bigger, but you retain the quality if you're on the like the highest levels here, and might choose to continue using that if you are so inclined. Proxy Media H.264, this is really if you want the smallest file sizes, but this is not suitable for grading, and it's also not great for editing. It's just if you are low on space and you need the smallest file size possible, then you can go to H.264. Let's say I want a low resolution proxy so that I can quickly edit, and I'm using it only for edit. I'm not using it for fusion and color, so I go maybe to the lowest resolution, and I might also reduce, so the lowest quality codec, and I might also reduce the media resolution. Now you can manually choose it, so this will always, you know, cut the resolution that is given on your media files, cut it either in half or quarter and so on. If you choose automatically, what that means is it looks at your timeline resolution from the project settings and then decides on any of the settings above that still satisfy your timeline resolution. So if you have an Ultra HD timeline but have 8K footage, right, you could it could cut it in quarter and still have the full resolution for your current timeline resolution. You might see a difference once you zoom in, but if you don't zoom, if you don't do anything else, it basically optimizes towards your timeline without sacrificing. If you choose it manually here, you might end up with resolutions below your timeline resolution, which is also fine if you want that for acceleration. So let's say I choose 1/8, which is like really low, but should be great to demonstrate the differences. So let me choose this. And then I can choose one or multiple clips. So let's say I want to have my 6K. Let me order by resolution. Let's take the high resolution one. So 6K, 3 Ultra HD. So let me select all of them. Just right click, generate proxy media. I can click this. And it generates it in the background. And then if you want to see what you have for proxy media, you can right click and enable those columns in the media pool. So you have a proxy and also proxy media path if you want to see. You can move these around, right, if it doesn't appear right here. So here I see the path where it was created and the resolution at which it was. Sorry, that's the regular resolution. Here is the proxy. Let me bring this over here. So this is the proxy. I have none for most of my files, and for the three files where I just created it, I have the proxy with this low resolution. If I look at my folder, I now have under Resolve Proxy Media, so in the determined folder, I have here videos, and I see here that the original file path where this was coming from was maintained. So I have kind of replicated the file path that this media is coming from in this proxy folder, which is really great because you may use the proxy files even in different places. So you can still easily find on disk where they are, what they're good for. You could use them in different software. You can also unlink and relink them. So for example, right click and let's say I don't like the resolution here, 480. Let's say I made a mistake during proxy generation or some proxies aren't exactly the way I want them to be. So I can unlink the proxy media. And if I relink just like this, let's say relink link proxy media, I just have to choose the proxy media folder and it will automatically find again the matching subfolder. So the relinking really works well without searching, without anything. But I can do something else. I could also unlink. Let's say I change my settings in the project settings. Let's say I want a different type of proxy, maybe even for certain files. For some reason, I want to change my proxy setting. Let's go from 1/8 to 1/4, save, create the proxy again. So you saw the 480 resolution before, and now that I have changed the settings, I have just replaced these two proxy files with a different proxy. So I can do this, and I can even switch. The older proxy files were not deleted, so I can even have, in theory, I can have multi-levels of proxy files. So if I wanted to switch them out again, I could unlink again and replace them. So, or I can directly go to link. Unlink is implicit, so I can directly go to link. And here now, in this case, I have two clips, and this one has a version number at the end. So yeah, that was the current one. So here that was not very smart because it ended up in the same folder. Typically you wouldn't do that, but what is quite conceivable that you may create a very low resolution proxy for editing, and you do your fast editing. Maybe you have your 100 hours of documentary footage. You make a super fast proxy on all of that just to skim the footage, work fast through it, maybe also on a low-powered computer, you know, or work through it, and then when you're done, you have your timeline, and maybe for some of the clips you want a higher quality. That would be possible, so you could switch it. In that case, you would probably want to put them in separate proxy folders, change the folder as well, or manually move them on disk so that you don't get confused. So these settings are possible, and they give you a lot of flexibility. They also give you the option to generate your proxy media outside. So here I showed you how I can do it directly in Resolve, which is of course very convenient. But if you are embedded in some larger workflow, and maybe you have some I don't know, media encoder or some other software for creating proxy files, or maybe you are using cameras which where you have proxy recording directly on set, for example, you can use that also the same way. So you can link those proxy files. Those proxy files should have the same duration, so you can't shorten them. They should have the same duration, and they should have matching time code. So I think if you use time code, so that's a requirement. And otherwise, you should be able to flexibly exchange your proxies if you have that. Let me show a bit more how I use this in Resolve. So first of all, I have to activate it, of course. So right now I'm looking at the original media, but if I want to see the proxy, I can choose here, use proxy media if available. And for this clip, it is available, and I see on my screen that it got a bit more blurry. Maybe you don't see it. Let me zoom a bit, then you definitely see it. So now we see pixels on her face, and if I turn it off, I'm back to the original media. Keep in mind that this is for loading and decoding from file, not so much for the onward processing. So with the proxy media, and it's the same for optimized media, with the proxy or optimized media, I have accelerated my decoding, so my processor needs less time to decode, and I may have accelerated the loading from disk if the files are smaller. If I do like low quality, small file size proxies, then the files are smaller. And if disk space is a consideration, which nowadays it is less and less, but if it is a consideration, if that is a bottleneck, I can circumvent it here. What I have not done is I have not changed the timeline resolution at which effects are being processed, right? So if I now do color grading effects on this for some reason, or if I do fusion effects on this, I will still have those effects will still process on the timeline resolution. So for that, there's a different setting which is a bit unrelated. So not totally, but you have the proxy timeline proxy resolution, and you have the resolution of your timeline itself. So if you have an HD timeline, you load proxy files into them, the files are getting loaded faster. If you zoom, you may see artifacts, but your timeline resolution is still the same. So any effects that process on the timeline in the color page will still process with the same computational effort. Even worse, in Fusion, I typically go back to the original media resolution. So here in this case, I see I'm on a 6K original media, because typically in Fusion, I want to be able to use more than what I might need in the edit timeline, because I might do effects which can benefit from additional resolution. So I have my original media resolution, but I can still activate the proxy. So if I activate the proxy media, it's being used here, and I can demonstrate it again if I scale. Let's say I make it transform and zoom up. Let's go, I don't know, size factor 10 or so. Was that enough to see it? Maybe even 20. Let me, sorry, I need to, yeah, bring it into the viewer. Let me move that over to her face. Maybe we can see it better here. So this is currently the enlarged nose. And if I turn the proxy off, you may notice that nothing happens immediately. And that's because of the Fusion cache. So the file was loaded. After it was loaded, it got cached. Even if it's just one frame, you have the green line here, right? And if you change this, it will not change on the frames that were cached before. So right now I am looking at the original file. If I turn it on, I might see it for new frames that are not cached here. Now I have immediately the super blurry pixels, right? If I go back, I still have the original. So just keep that in mind if you're switching, because Fusion has the memory cache. This is not on the file system, this is in RAM. So because you already loaded in RAM, changing a setting there will no longer have any impact unless you it's recomputed. It will be recomputed, for example, if you do here purge cache, and then you might also pre-render current frame, and now it's loaded again from disk. The current frame is recomputed and it's loading again, and now it's loading based on the proxy file. Yeah, so that's the same principle again with optimized media. I'm just showing it with proxy file, right, so that you're aware of this. This also shows you a limitation of the proxy or optimized media. It means that if you are going to optimized media, Fusion may be a little bit faster of loading things into RAM. Right, so if the decoding goes faster, it can load into RAM faster. But afterwards, once your RAM is filled, it doesn't matter anymore, because Fusion will still compute the frame based on the full resolution frame internally. So if I put any heavy tool on top, let's say I do a grid warp, which is one of the tools which unfortunately are not GPU optimized yet. So this tool might take some. Sorry, I should bring it into the viewer. So this tool warps the image. It doesn't matter, but this tool processes quite slowly, and it doesn't care if the media before was optimized or not, because the processing itself of this tool is the dominant factor right now. I don't really care about the original media file. I care about the performance of this particular tool, and that tool still gets the full resolution. So keep this in mind when working with these optimizations. They are really great when it comes to editing. They're really great when really your file loading is your bottleneck, your file loading and file decoding. If that's your bottleneck, they're really helpful. If your bottleneck are processing steps afterwards, if that's your bottleneck, then this will have only low impact, only so far as that your processor has maybe a bit more capacity, because the loading and decoding takes less processing GPU power, so you have more available. That's great. But once it's cached, in case of Fusion, that doesn't matter anymore. So once it's cached, it's just irrelevant completely. In color, we don't have this type of memory cache, so there the impact might be a bit more, but again, the impact is the first loading, not the processing. I can also filter by the proxy media, so if you have thousands of clips and you want to filter, you can just go on the search and you can filter by proxy. Why is this not in alphabetical order? Anyhow, would be convenient. You can filter by proxy, and you can, for example, search for all the clips that have no proxy, or you can search for all the clips that have a certain proxy resolution. For example, if you want to see if you have any proxy resolutions that were too low. In principle, I should also be able to do smart bins to find the clips which do not have proxy media or which have proxy media. However, that feature is currently missing. I hope it's being added. So in the media pool, I have here the different media pool properties. And in principle, if I do a smart bin here, right click, add smart bin, I also have media pool properties, but under this list, I do not find proxy at the moment, which is kind of sad. I hope they're adding it here. I might still use smart bins. I might use it for kind of the opposite thing. I might use smart bins to find all the clips that could benefit from optimization, right, or from proxy generation. So I might use the smart bin to, let's say, go on the video codec or video format, where is it? For edit convenience, it's not in alphabetical order, too bad. So here, video codec contains, and I can look, well, this is all Apple ProRes. Maybe I want something which is, I want to find all the H.264 files. For example, I could, you know, H.264 and create a bin like this. And maybe I want to add another filter on the resolution and only take the ones which are, you know, high resolution. And I could, you know, go on the resolution is, in this case, I have an Ultra HD clip 3:2160. So I don't have a higher sized H.264 right now. But this way I could create a smart bin, and then if I have more files, you know, I can just find all the files that match this in my project and then say, okay, let's generate proxies for all those files and yeah, do it this way. That's pretty much it about proxy files. Now let me show you what the difference is when I'm going at optimized media. Optimized media is the older feature in DaVinci Resolve, which was there before version 17. It has some advantages and also some disadvantages, especially at the moment in version 17.1, where I am at the moment, because some things which used to be there have gone away, and I hope that Blackmagic Design brings them back, but there are currently some handling issues. So let's start at the beginning. First of all, you also have a resolution to decide upon. So you have here your optimized media resolution, same as the proxy, also same settings, right, for the resolution. And for your codec, almost the same as proxy. You have, in addition, uncompressed, like if you really need the, you know, highest possibility, no loss codec type, and you do not have H.264. The reason you don't have H.264 is, well, first of all, it's not much of an optimization. It's not a good codec for editing in general. Second of all, H.264 encodes multiple frames together. And with optimized media, that's exactly not happening, because optimized media creates individual files for individual frames in the background. That is something that Resolve can work quite well with. Resolve can also work well with the proxy files. It's just a kind of different way of storage. Let me show it to you. Let me say I optimized one clip, generate optimized media. Here it is, like just once above the proxy. And now if I look into my cache clip location, it's not in the proxy media, but it's in the cache clip folder. If I go there to optimized media, I find this cryptic name, and under this cryptic name is another cryptic name that basically refers back to media IDs in the Resolve database. And inside there, there's just a file sequence of so and so many frames. So each individual frame has its own file. So that's how optimized media is handled. It is useless if you want to use it in other applications, because that's kind of Blackmagic Design's own container here. So you can't use it outside. You can't really put it to a different location. You can't relink it. So all that part is not there. The advantage is, first of all, DaVinci Resolve handles this quite efficiently, but I believe proxy files are also doing quite well, so I don't think there's an immediate performance difference between proxy and optimized media. However, this concept here works for partial optimization. So you could have this timeline, and maybe you have done some editing. Let's say you have shortened this already. Perhaps you have done the editing on a low-res proxy. Yeah, you have done some quick editing or just assembled some clips in the timeline, and then you say, okay, I only want to optimize this, so I can right-click and generate optimized media from here instead of from the media pool, so I can generate it from here. And in this case, it is optimizing only what is currently used in the timeline. So that's something which is more efficient. So especially if you are thinking about optimizing for codec, not for resolution, let's say you optimize with a full media resolution but want to go to one of these high quality HDR codecs, they can get quite large, so you can get a lot of file size. Do you really want to do this with all your media? Like if you have, you know, 100 hours of documentary footage, maybe not. Maybe you want to do that level of encoding only once before you start the grading or before you start maybe VFX. So I have saved some disk space in the beginning. If I later change the edit and I want to access the optimized media again, then I would have to right click and generate optimized media again, and it would regenerate the optimized media now with the full length of the new edit. Right, so that's the advantage of optimized media. A second advantage is that It is used automatically across the DaVinci Resolve database. So if you use the same clip in another project, if you make a copy of the project or something like this, or you have maybe some clips which you put in a power bin, which are shared across different projects, then also the optimized media would be shared across. So you have it available in different places. There are some disadvantages which have kind of popped up since they made these changes to optimized media. So since version 17, optimization from the timeline is possible, wasn't possible before. And since version 17, the shared optimized media across projects in the same database. So that's a new concept since version 17. But there are also some things that they removed with that upgrade. So I'm not sure I can call it an upgrade in that sense. But what is gone, we can no longer delete the optimized media from here, which does make sense because if it is shared across project, you don't want to accidentally delete something in one project, which is maybe used in another project of the same database. So that's, I guess, why the button delete optimized media is no longer available here. You would have to go to the file system and delete it from here. The problem is here, I can't really see which optimized media belongs to which project. I just have these IDs and that's very inconvenient. So I'm not exactly sure if you have multiple projects and do multiple levels of optimized media and then one project ends, what do you do? Right, so that's really one problem. If you only work with one project at a time, I don't see that's the problem. You can just delete the whole folder at the end, right? But if you want to make use of that sharing across project, but then, yeah, how do you clean up? So that's a bit difficult at the moment. Another problem is there used to be the same way I see here, proxy media and proxy media path. There was also an option to enable optimized media to see which clip actually has optimized media. That option somehow disappeared. Don't ask me why, it's just gone. I hope it comes back. Also, it was possible to create smart bins to search for optimized media. That's also gone at the moment, at least on my computer. Maybe next update, who knows, maybe it's back again. But right now that's just missing. And furthermore, if I right click on the clip, I can, which was this? This was this clip. If I right click, I can say generate optimized media, but it always says generate optimized media even if I optimized it before. So effectively, I have no way of seeing which clip currently has optimized media and which clip doesn't. So that's, I believe that's what I would classify as a bug. I hope Blackmagic Design agrees and fixes that. So that's a bit of the problem at the moment. Nevertheless, you have the setting here. You can enable the optimized media. It does work when you have created it. I checked that before. And you even have both. In theory, you can enable both, in which case you are probably only confusing yourself. But if both are enabled, it uses the proxy media. At least that's what I figured out in my tests. But I would obviously not do this because, you know, you either use proxy or you use optimized media, so you enable one of them. You could combine both for a more advanced workflow. So one idea could be to create proxy media in the beginning, a very low res proxy for quick editing. Let's say you have 100 hours of documentary footage, you create proxy on all of it. You have super fast access for editing, even on low powered workstations, you create your edit. And maybe before grading, you switch to a high quality optimized media, only for what is left in the final timeline. So then you use the higher level codec on the shorter segment. So again, disk space is less of a concern in that situation. And then you could, in principle, switch between them just here. Given the current problems of optimized media, that I can't really delete it from here, that I can't even find it from here, I would currently be very cautious in using optimized media. I might even, decide to not use it unless you have simple projects where you know, okay, I'm just optimizing everything, or I optimize the whole timeline and later I delete everything. Otherwise, your optimized media pretty much behaves the same way as your proxy media. So also with respect to fusion or color, Again, it is just the file decoding, disk reading, file decoding part. The rest of your processing remains pretty much unaffected. In Fusion, again, keep in mind you have a memory cache in Fusion. So if you switch a setting while working in Fusion, if you turn optimized media on or off or proxy media on or off, keep in mind your cache is already there. So if you started working on a proxy and then need the full resolution, you need to clear the Fusion cache first. So in color, you don't have the problem there. We don't have this memory cache in that way. So there it is instant. There is one more type of proxy file that is only applicable if you are in Fusion and you are using EXR file sequences or you're using Fusion loader nodes, which typically load EXR file sequences. Or if you're in Fusion Studio, that would apply there as well. So if I go into Fusion, I might, let me remove this again here, I might load EXR file sequences directly in Fusion via the Fusion loader node. I have a separate video on loader and saver nodes, and also in my compositing course, I talk about EXR files and what they are good for and why they are so popular in VFX. But let's say I have the same sequence here as an EXR file sequence, or you may have a 3D render as an EXR file sequence. You can load it with a loader node. And in this case, it's actually the same clip. I just rendered it as an EXR file sequence, which is quite common for Fusion. So if you have this, you have here a file name, which is directly pointing to disk. So this is circumventing the media pool from DaVinci Resolve. It's directly going to disk. And you also have a proxy file name. And if I want, I can load a proxy file directly into here. So let's say I also have an HD proxy, which I rendered before. I can load that directly here. And this one is used under two conditions. Basically, you need the proxy on. If I turn this on here under right click on the transport controls, right click proxy. So if this is enabled, then this is used if you also have a timeline proxy mode. And I will talk more about proxy modes in another video because there are proxy levels in Edit and proxy levels in Fusion, and I will dive a bit more into this into another video. Here I'm just talking about the decoding part, but because the decoding and file reading part is different here, I want to mention it at this place. So proxy file name here, file name there. If you turn this on and have a proxy level set, then this loader node is now reading from this file. Works the same way in Fusion Studio. This kind of workflow is different from the Resolve workflow because in Fusion you usually don't optimize. I mean, you don't optimize in Fusion, you just start with whatever media you want to use. So if you need to convert, for example, raw media you don't use in Fusion, you first export it into EXR sequences or DPX sequence or whatever, and then you load it directly. So there's no need to have this kind of optimization or proxy file workflow. The only purpose of it is if you're also using lower quality previews in Fusion, then matching to this lower quality preview, you can have a lower quality proxy file. So in Fusion, it's kind of thought together. The thinking is you always have full resolution, full quality for your normal file, and then you may work with lower resolution. And if at the same time you want a faster loading file, you could, for that lower resolution, have a matching proxy file and have the proxy setting and the file resolution kind of ideally matching so that it loads faster from disk and the remaining proxy work in Fusion is accelerated at the same time. Again, proxy setting in Fusion is another topic for another tutorial. So we have this, we have the optimized media and the proxy. And the edit info for Fusion. I hope you enjoyed this. The main consideration is about your workflow between proxy and optimized media. When are you using it? Do you prefer the manual generation, maybe even outside, or do you have the more automatic Resolve style of optimized media, which you can do from the timeline with the current disadvantages of not really seeing what you're doing? So these are the two levels of generation. And yeah, with this you can set up your workflow further. This was again more in this tutorial than I anticipated, but there is still more coming about performance in Fusion. If you have specific questions, let me know in the comments below. Also, click on the like and subscribe to stay tuned, and see you next time. Cheers.